instrumentation.
Produced by Soundman and NVX Audio. Premium iPad dash kits and custom dash mods at soundman.co. High quality car stereo, amp, speakers, and vehicle specific bass packages.
Bass!
NVX.com. We are also sponsored by US Alternators and downforsoundshop.com.
Oh, good morning. I'm still in here sleeping from last episode.
This isn't going so swell.
Today I'll continue cleaning up the mule's wiring. We take a look at the new NVX DSP, and I finally bedlined the mule with Herculiner. What if it turns out like shit?
How come this wire is so long? Where do these go? What is this? How's this supposed to be? Why can't I get to this side? Because I've mounted it too close to the fucking wall? Could that be why? Shit! Why is my fuel pump disconnected? What happens if I... This looks nice. Oh, that turned out swell. Yeah. Who did that? Who did this? Oh, that was me. As Coolio once said, look at the situation they got me facing.
Awful.
Oh, no, Roger.
Dreadful.
No.
Terrible.
No.
Stupid.
Does this look any different? I'm trying to pull the slack out of some of these. I got these kind of ran together. This will go straight like this. I gotta pull some slack out of these. So this is gonna be like a little by little situation. I think it's starting to look better. This little shit pile is what I need to deal with next.
Now I need to make a spot for the mule's new amplification unit.
I'll probably have to put it down low like this, and we'll put the DSP up here maybe. If I do the RCAs on this side, I'll be able to get to the adjustments, and then I'll be able to easily get to the wiring on this side. Speaker wires, I'll go in there.
How does that look? Ow, my fucking elbow.
This is a nice little amplification unit. Oh, you son of a fucking fat whore. Shit! Fucking scoot my ass over here and sit on a bunch of fucking tools. Got a screwdriver up my ass. Bullshit. Ass. Bullshit. You son of a dickless bitch. Come on, why am I having trouble? God damn. Now she's hanging by one screw. Son of a dickless whore. Oh, baby. Zapped it on there. All right, look at that, huh? Take me to your jungle, where the rain is warm and the birds fly. Take me to your kingdom. Yeah, take me to the, yeah, take me to the. Take me to your jungle, where the rain is warm and the birds fly. Take me to your kingdom. It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
I was fabricating a log and reading comments, and some dumb idiot is butthurt because I'm downgrading the mule's stereo system. After I explained why, in lengthy detail, I put the Macintosh amp and the big ass box in there when the mule was a Volkswagen. Then I did the Subaru swap and ended up with no room for the electronicals, and it was a jumbled up mess. And he still wants me to, and I'm saving the Macintosh amp for my next stereo system. Now he spoiled the surprise.
Oh no, Rod.
Dreadful.
No. Terrible.
What a dumbass idiot. He wants me to put too big of an amp and box in the place where it won't fit. If that's what you want, come over and open up your butt cheeks and I'll do it. I'll put it up. I'll put my 3-inch tweeter up there while I'm at it.
Man,
what happened? Right now, it's not time.
If you want me to put somewhere it's not going to fit, that's what I'm going to I'm gonna put it where it's not going to fit. I plan to run the new NVX DSP, but it needs to have a specific feature. So we're going to unbox it, hook it up, and test it out to make sure it'll work for my particular use case scenario. With the Mule speakers I have in there, they're actively crossed over. So I need to make sure this has a band pass crossover setting for the mids, because I need to cross over the tweeters. Then I need to high pass and low pass the mids. Then I could low pass the subwoofer. You see what I'm saying? Do you get what I'm saying? Do you understand what I'm getting at? So let's give this a little connection. Connect this with a connector, connecticate. This has a remote in and a remote out. That's horny. Let's take a look at the instruction manual. This is you because you don't know how to hook it up. Setting up the unit. Gain matching, link channel, PEQ, frequency cutting, menu instructions. Okay, give me a second. I'm gonna wire this up, hook it up, and I'm gonna fucking peel the sticker off for desirability of the cinematics. We'll dilly dick around with it. Now in the Mule, I have a Hybrid Audio LaGaudia L3 we're using as tweeters. This graph I pulled up shows the frequency response of the L3. It plays almost all the way up to 20K and all the way down to about 150. And we're using those pretty much as tweeters. So we're gonna go to high pass filter and we're gonna go 200 and up. 24 dB. So our tweeters are gonna play 200 all the way up to 20K. You know what, let's take some stress off of them and we'll do 300. Now we have a L7 mid. Those are gonna be channels 3 and 4. We're gonna high pass those at 80 Hertz and up. So the tweeters are gonna play 300 and up. The mids will play 80 and up on channels 3 and 4. And now we're gonna go low pass filter. The mids on channels 3 and 4 need to play 300 and down. That way the sixes will play 300 to 80. That's the band pass. They're gonna be high pass filtered and low pass filtered. So let's see if that's possible. Dial this down to 300 Hertz. 24 decibel cutoff. This has 12 or 24 dB slope. Okay, so that's low pass filter on channel 3. Now we'll do low pass filter on channel 4. Okay, so that works. Now we're gonna low pass 5 and 6 for the sub. That's gonna play 80 and down. So that's channel 5, 80 Hertz low pass. So that's pretty cool. This will do everything we need. We're using a deck, so this is gonna work perfect for us. We're gonna go deck, front, rear, and sub in. This is gonna go out to the amp. We'll be able to adjust crossover and EQ. We'll throw a RTA on it when everything's hooked up. Bada bing, bada bang, bang, boom, bang, boom. It's got delay, high pass, low pass, parametric EQ, individual levels, IO configuration. All right, so we'll probably zap this baby right here. Zap! And we can still get to the adjustments on the amp. And then we'll run our outputs. Right into there with some short RCA cables.
It doesn't matter.
I was meditating on my yoga mat and some more spiritual car advice came to me. The car doesn't make the man. The man makes the car. Unless you're Mark Zuckerberg, the car audio nerd. He buys stock Jeeps. He's never even popped the hood. If he needs to pop the hood, he's paying someone else to do it. What a poser. Then he proceeds to install a baby stereo system that doesn't even bump. Wait till he sees my next system.
No!
No! All right, now if we were to take a look in here, you fucking bitch. This is pretty much ready. Oh no. Except this part. Oh no. We gotta get the motor back in here and get everything kinda hooked back up. I'm thinking of bed lining it up to here, and then we'll do this side section later. We'll need some paint rolled over the edge before we... But I gotta bedline these sides before the motor goes in. So, I don't know what to do. Now I'm going to try out the Herculiner roll-on bedliner system. I'm gonna pull this hard line out of here. Oh, shoot. Oh yeah. Look. So I'm gonna cover the transaxial and then mask off some of this shit. So I'm gonna pull the airline bulkheads out of there, mask off the wiring and some brake lines. Doesn't matter what you did, Doug. Baby. Okay, we got the Herculiner bedliner kit. Do it yourself, baby. Please do not shake can. Open with care. Contents may explode. All right, we're gonna stir it up with this fucking bad boy. Pour it in here. Stir as we go. Gonna roll it on with this Hercu roller.
Hercules, Hercules, as Eddie Murphy once said.
What if I spin it and it fucking just spits shit all over my new work boots? Huh?
Can I open it or not?
Oh yeah, oh this is gonna just fucking spin shit all over my fucking... Oh. Okay, here goes nothing. Oh, it's thick on the bottom, dude. Oh no, this is a horrible idea. Oh. It's thickening. Look at it thicken. I need a bucket of fucking solvent to put this thing in when I'm done. And I didn't get the bucket. Now I'm sitting here stuck with this here. Like this. Okay, will it stand up? Oh no. Ooh, that's a healthy amount. Now we're gonna cover the lid with the lid. Let's give it a test brush in the corners real quick. Oh yeah, that looks pretty good. Oh yeah, this is gonna be swell. Oh, this is actually quite swell. I'm just gonna go quick around the corners real quick. Ugh. This has got a nice texture to it. I'm gonna keep stirring this up as I go to keep the particles, the uniformity of the particles.
Oh yeah. This is gonna be fucking swell.
Oh no, it's getting all over the fucking floor. Shit. I should have put a piece of cardboard under there. You know what, this would be good for the outside of a subwoofer box. I like this. The Raptor liner is good, but the prep sucks because that shit gets overspray everywhere. So you gotta mask off your entire fucking shop if you don't want that shit everywhere. That's why I chose the Herculean liner this time. That's the first coat. I'll let this sit for an hour or more. And then I'll stir up another tray and hit it with the second coat. It looks really good. The texture's good. It covers pretty good. I could see through it in some spots. So it will need two or three coats to get it fully saturated. But I think it'll work pretty good. I was able to get down all in the nooks and crannies with the brush. A car will never satisfy your inner being. Your involvement with the vehicle is what may bring one's self inner joy. You can satisfy yourself in your car, or on your car, or on someone else's car. But the car itself will never satisfy. But your car will never be perfect and will always piss you off. But you may pop a boner if you buy new car parts and attempt to install them. All right, it's been an hour. Whoa, oh, bullshit. A cheap turd often brings more joy than a high car payment, is what I learned. Your wife will never be satisfied in the backseat of your car, but she will in mine. All right, baby, we did it. We god dang did it.
Woohoo! Take a look at that.
It turned out pretty even. I tried to work out the blotchiness as much as possible. Looks pretty horny. Pretty fucking horny. So I'm leaving, I'll let this dry and then we'll pull all the plastic off. Could have done this without the Herculiner bedliner kit. Looks like I ate a handful of gravel, took a shit in a bucket, and mixed it with lacquer thinner. It's the same shit. The NVX DSP looks like it'll work. The Herculiner turned out Herculean. Next episode, I'll be able to plop the motor back in the mule. If you enjoy the videos, please support the episodes by joining our Patreon. We're sending gifts from around the shop to some of our loyal Patreon supporters. We'll choose more next episode.